children, today we are going to learn a new lesson in geography, chapter 4, Air. Air. Our earth is surrounded by a huge blanket of air called atmosphere. All living beings on this earth depend on the atmosphere for their survival. It provides us the air we breathe and protects us from the harmful effects of the sun rays. Without this blanket of protection, we would be baked alive by the heat of the sun during day and get frozen during night. Plant needs nitrogen for their survival. They cannot take nitrogen directly from the air. Bacteria that live in the soil and roots of some plants take nitrogen from the air and change its form so that plants can use it. Next one, we are going to see the structure of the atmosphere. Our atmosphere is derived into five layers, starting from the Earth's surface. These are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. First, we are going to learn about what is troposphere. This is the most important layer of the atmosphere. Its average height is 13 km. The air we breathe exists here. Weather phenomena like rainfall, fog, and hailstorm occur in this layer. Next comes stratosphere. It extends up to a height of 50 km, almost free from clouds and associated weather phenomena, ideal for flying aeroplanes. Next contains a layer of ozone gas. The next, that is above stratosphere, is the mesosphere. This is the third layer of the atmosphere. It lies above the stratosphere. It extends up to a height of 80 km. Meteoroids burn up in this layer on entering from the space. The next layer is thermosphere. Temperature rises very rapidly with increasing height. Ionosphere is a part of this. It extends between 80 to 400 km. Helps in radio transmission. Radio waves transmitted from Earth are reflected back by this layer. And the last layer is, that is exosphere. This is the uppermost layer of the atmosphere. And this layer has very thin air. Light gases like helium and hydrogen float into the space from here. Next, we are going to see about temperature and air pressure. An important factor that influences the distribution of temperature is insolation. Insolation is the incoming solar energy intercepted by the Earth. The amount of insolation decreases from the equator towards the poles. The standard unit of measuring temperature is degrees Celsius. It was invented by Andreas Celsius. Next, we are going to see about air pressure. Highest at sea level and decrease with height. Horizontally influenced by temperature of air at a given place. High temperature, when will be the high temperature? If air gets heated and rises. Okay, then low pressure area. So there will be high temperature. Low pressure is associated with cloudy skies and wet weather. Lower temperature will be where air is cool and heavy, and there will be high pressure area. High pressure is associated with clear and sunny skies. Air always moves from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. Here the questions can be asked, what is the difference between high temperature and lower temperature? Differentiate between low pressure and high pressure. So you should know the correct answer. Next one is wind. Movement of air from high pressure area to low pressure areas is called as wind. Winds can be broadly divided into three types. First, permanent winds, seasonal winds, and local winds. Now we are going to see about permanent winds. The trade winds westerlies and easterlies. Next, blow constantly throughout the year in a particular direction. That is, they will be permanent. So, it is called as permanent wind. Seasonal wind. So, from the name itself, it is season. Okay. These winds change their direction in different seasons. Example, monsoons in India. And the third one is local winds. Blow only during a particular period of the day or year in a small area. Example, land and sea breeze. Hot and dry local wind of northern plains of India. It is called loo. The last topic is moisture. Moisture in the air at any time is known as humidity. When the air is full of water vapor, we call it a humid day. As the air gets warmer, its capacity to hold the water vapor increases, and so it becomes more and more humid. Precipitation that comes down to the earth in liquid form is called rain. Rainfall is very important for the survival of plants and animals. It brings fresh water to the earth's surface. If rainfall is less, water scarcity and drought occur. On the other hand, if it is more, floods takes place. On the basis of mechanism, there are three types of rainfall. First one is conventional rainfall, orographic rainfall, and cyclonic rainfall. Questions for these sessions. First question, write the composition of air in the atmosphere. Second, draw the structure of atmosphere. Third, define mean and explain its types. Fourth, what are the types of rainfall? This question you have to refer page number 26 in the content book. Thank you, children.